Hi, this is Anne for SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to add fonts to Silhouette Studio. All right, let's get started. All right, I'm going to go out to defont.com, and this site is really great for free fonts. It has a lot of really good ones for Cricut and Cameo. And one thing you really need to check when you're using this site, a lot of these say free for personal use right over here, and that is fine if you're just going to use it for friends and family and you're not going to get paid for the design that you make with it. If you want to sell the design on a t-shirt or something like that, you need to make sure it says free for commercial use, and then there will be licensing terms on that. So usually that'll be in the README after you download it. I'm really liking this Lilybed script here, so I'm going to go ahead and download this. If you're on Chrome, it'll put it right down here at the bottom left, and you can just click on this caret and choose Show in Finder, and this will show you where the font is on your system. For me, it goes into my downloads, and I would guess that for 95% of you, it'll go into your downloads folder. So this comes in as a zip file. And so if you're on a Mac, you'll just need to double click it and it'll create a little folder with some files inside. If you're on a PC, you'll probably want to right click and choose extract or extract all. And you'll have the same result. You'll get a little folder with some files inside. Let's take a look at this README text file. It does say there's a link to purchase the full version and a commercial version. So you can go to that link if you wanted to create items to sell with this font. Okay, so here is the font. It'll either end in TTF or OTF. Both of those are the font file. So on a Mac, all we have to do is double click this and then install the font. On a PC, you'll right click and choose install font or something similar like that. Okay, let's go to Silhouette Studio and open that up. I'm using the free basic version, but it'll work the same way in the other Silhouette versions too, like Designer and Business. One thing to note, if you already had Silhouette Studio open and you don't see the font that you installed, you'll probably want to completely quit out of that program and then restart it. And after that, it should show up. All right, let's create some new text. I'll click over here on the A button, and then I'll click once over here on my canvas. And I'm just going to type hello. Okay, now I'll come up here to the font. And our font's name is Lilybud. So I'm just going to highlight this and start typing in Lilybud and hit return. Okay, you can also choose it this way, but in Silhouette Basic, it's a little hard for me for some reason to get to my fonts by just choosing the drop-down, trying to scroll to them. So it's easier for me if I just type it in. But anyway, here it is. I'm going to increase the size a little bit. And it's coming in really nice. Everything is connected perfectly. That's kind of a rare thing. All right, and as you probably know, with script fonts, wherever they overlap, it actually will cut these little pieces. And so we'll probably want to weld these. So let's come up here to the weld option. All right, and it's all one piece and it'll cut beautifully now. So now we would just go over to send. And I don't have a Silhouette device connected right now, but you would just choose that and then go from there. And that's it. It is that easy to get new fonts into Silhouette Studio, Basic, Designer, or Business editions. If you like this video and you want to see more like it, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell beside it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, thank you.